the Faberge Album of the Month. This award is presented for individuality of style, honesty of performance, and achievement in the field of record albums. Tonight, the Faberge Album of the Month award goes to Three Dog Night, Naturally.
I'm glad we're going to have enough time when we start the next album. We'll have a lot more time than we've had in the past, you know. As far as, instead of being rushed like the last album, you know, month.
Yeah, it worked. It worked out.
It worked out.
You know, the pressure kind of...
It was more like the last things we did, there wasn't any planned schedule of songs that we were going to do. You know, the thing is, like, some of the songs that were produced right in the studio that came up, like, a lot of those songs weren't even, we didn't even figure we were going to use them. And then at the very end, when time came down to such pressure, we ended up using them.
Yeah.
I wonder if people misunderstood the title, Naturally. You know, no overdubs on it. It's think we mean
it could really sound
naturally.
I wonder what they, because
we didn't have time to get those little quote stating, you know, that we how we approach the album, try to do it as natural as possible
with our own people and no overdubs of no other strange musicians.
I've thought about that. What they think we mean when we say naturally.
Yeah. And I just think on like our next album or one of our albums coming up, we should have liner notes. We have never had liner notes on one album. I mean, we just kind of have, most groups have the same problem. You're like a zombie. You either sing or else you play a guitar, and or you go on a talk show and they don't, you know, you play and sing rock and roll. They don't want to talk to you. They just don't think you have a brain. I mean, I get the feeling sometimes, maybe it's defensive, but
this album does feel
people.
After hearing it, like it's done now, I don't know, it has a nice and natural feel to me. I mean, like the songs, I'm happy with all of them.
Yeah.
Like I know some of the other albums, look back and say, well, maybe I could.
Yeah. Have you seen the sunlight falling through the hay? Felt a warm mouth on you in the summer's air. Running in a field of brown, laughing, rolling on the ground, smiling as she pulls you down. That's the way she feels about you. That's the way she feels about you. If your dreams can wake you screaming in the night, she can touch your face and take away the flight. Like a tree in a meadow wind, she will bend to take you in. Makes no difference where you've been. That's the way she feels about you. That's the way she feels about you. If you wake up dreaming, scared about what you're dreaming, you know she is there, she can share. You know where she cares about you. In the morning, wake up laughing with the day. She will smile with her eyes to stay. Like the sunshine warms the sand, she will touch you with her hand. Touch and make you understand. That's the way she feels about you. That's the way she feels about you.
You know, basically, like starting with, yeah, you know, with the song Can't Get Enough of It, in the beginning there were like, when I had my own group, I had like two songs were my favorite. And so far I've managed to get both of them on, at least one of them on one of our albums and the other on the other. And I think this one here, I think I had a lot of fun doing, because I always wanted to do it, was Can't Get Enough of It.
Oh, yeah.
So I've always dug the song and always liked it. But it, to me, I felt that it was never done R&B-ish or funky enough. And I wanted to try and get that with this song.
I can't ever let you go. I feel like I need.
honest, when One Man Band was a choice for a single, I wasn't like very excited about it. You know, I just, it was difficult for me to relate to that song. But now, you know, I don't feel too, you know, really too upset about it. I don't know. What do you think about it?
Well, the thing that bothered me, this was like the first single that we've ever released, and which we didn't put out an album first. Remember, we only had two things finished.
Right, yeah, the people didn't
pick. And the record company wanted to release one. And I can see their point. They wanted to get something out, and it was time. But, Jimmy brought played that song for me, Liar, on an airplane, and I really did like the song. I'm glad everyone else did it, and it was kind of fun doing it, because remember when we were here, we experimented to try to get a sound, because my voice was so croaky.
Yeah, the days.
And how did you come up with the idea?
Singing in the bathroom. Well, that was the only way, we tried everything, I think.
I think you tried every spot in the studio.
Inside a bass drum and in the hallway and so on. But
it was the right sound.
Yeah.
It really creates a sound.
Yeah, it was a good sound.
I think so, too. And I enjoy the song. I enjoy singing it. I really do.
Except we have to inform you that you're always going to be singing there now.
In the bathroom.
it's a great performance, I have to say that.
Thank you. You ran home, brother. You told me. You ran on me twice. Oh,
makes me feel better.
Thank you.
say.